We have our next finalist, Wei Gordon, is a PhD in the Tetrad, or sorry, is working towards her PhD in the Tetrad program. Got a little ahead of myself there. Don't get too excited. Her dissertation advisor is Nadav Ahituv, and her talk is entitled Uncovering the Sweet Secrets of Fruit-Eating Mammals.
We eat too much sugar. I just wolfed down bowls of Cinnamon Toast Crunch to get myself extra jazzed for Grad Slam. But really, it's impossible to avoid sugar. Diabetes is the 8th leading cause of death in the US, and more than 1 in 3 adults are pre-diabetic. So how can we alleviate some negative consequences of a high sugar diet? We can learn something from mammals that specialize on a high sugar diet. These mammals include fruit-eating bats and primates. Though we know fruit eaters eat more sugar, yet lower their blood sugar faster than non-fruit eaters, we don't know how traits like this arose at the molecular level. Little changes or mutations in DNA can result in changes to traits. Traits are encoded by DNA sequences called genes. Mutations in genes change traits, but mutations in DNA sequences around genes, called gene regulatory regions, change traits too. You can think of these regions as conductors. If genes are the instruments in an orchestra that creates a living being, then gene regulatory regions are the conductors that control when, where, and how much an instrument is played. I'm not the first person to ask a fruit eater, "What sugar secrets are you hiding?" Previous investigators have focused on finding mutations in genes, but only a few have been found. Because no one has examined gene regulatory regions, the conductors, I look to find mutations there that lead to fruit eater traits. I analyzed DNA of over 100 mammals to identify sequences with mutations only in fruit eaters. I found thousands. The next step was to test if these mutated sequences are gene regulatory regions. I selected a handful of sequences and I put them in front of genes that can light up into cells. If a sequence is a gene regulatory region, then a light gene is instructed to produce light I can see. Every fruit eater sequence I tested gave light. I was lit with excitement. Did I find sugar secrets? To test if the regulatory regions I discovered affect sugar metabolism, I put the fruit eater sequences into a non-fruit eater, the mouse, and I'm examining mouse development and response to high sugar. My regulatory region database offers secrets for high sugar adaptation. This can assist therapeutic developments like metabolic diseases like diabetes. I'm not saying I found a reason for us to eat as much Cinnamon Toast Crunch as we'd like, but I may have found a reason life can be just a little bit sweeter. Thank you.